Welcome to Radio Frequency and Micro Laboratory. In this video, we are going to discuss about measurement of guide wavelength and frequency. By using frequency meter, that is direct method, and by using slotted line method, that is indirect method. Now coming to the operational procedure. To perform any experiment, we require source with supply, a test bench and measuring devices. In this lab, we have measuring devices like SWR meter, CRO and ammeter. Who are for beginners, CRO and ammeter are the best option for take readouts. So, on power supply. First, we are going to on cooling fan, then measuring devices, then Clutch on power supply. By pressing power on button, power will be activated. After pressing HD mode, power goes upside. By using meter select switching, we can observe beam voltage, beam current and required voltages. Now, by selecting beam current mode, by varying beam voltage, we are going to set up to 20 milliamps of current. Then, in modulation, we have to keep AM mode, and at the time, these two probes will be activated. It is frequency and it is amplitude. By varying these two probes into middle portion, we can observe readings on your output. Now adjust the regular voltages and amplitude of the AM modulation. We have to maximize the readings. By adjusting these two variables, we have to maximize the readings. What are the readings as Imax? Don't confuse with beam current and Imax current. Beam voltages and currents are input to the klystron tube. And for the entire experiment, these values are constant. That's why we are going to take these readings above the tabular format. Coming to the Imax, it detects amount we are observing these values. And it is initially used for next further experiments. That's why it is called Imax or I-initial or I-input. Up to this point, procedure is same for every experiment. Now, we are going to discuss about direct method. It is very easy to perform the lab. Coming to direct method, it is easy to find out frequency. By using find out what frequency is inside the paper. By tuning this frequency meter, we are going to observe the readings on ammeter. Slightly while we are tuning this frequency meter, those components moves up direction or down direction according to rotation angle. At a certain point, we can observe dip on ammeter. So, when the dip is occurred, from there we have to take readings from frequency meter. Time readings of ammeter goes down rapidly. So, it is indicate that a dip on ammeter. Whenever we are getting a dip, the resonant frequency of frequency meter matches with frequency of wave. So we have to take readings from the frequency meter. Top of the frequency meter we have a vertical red line, and this red line matches with a number which is lying in between these two copper lines. We have to take that value. Correct. Right now I am getting 9.275 gigahertz as my frequency. After taking the readout, we have to detune the frequency meter. While we are detuning our frequency meter, our reading goes to the IMAX position, and it is set to the initial condition. In this manner, we are going to find out frequency from direct method. In this method, we are not able to find out wavelength. That's why we are shifting to the slotted line method. Line method. It is also known as indirect method, because first we are going to find out wavelength of the signal, and then by substituting this value into the standard formulas, we will get frequency. We measure the frequency by using tuner, direct readout meter, direct frequency meter. Right now, by using crystal detector and slotted section, we are going to perform this experiment. Output probe is connected to crystal detector and it is inserted on slotted line. Here we can observe a hole to insert crystal detector. After inserting, we have to this screw. If you are getting results minimum or low, then we have to adjust this plunger to get maximize our readings. Then coming to the slotted line section, here tunable probe we need to keep right most place. For slotted line section, tunable probe is shifted to right side most. Then we have to rotate slightly towards the generator. When we are rotating this tunable probe along the slotted line section, we will get successive maximas and minimas. We have to take any two successive maximas or minimas from this slotted line. By tuning this probe at a point, we'll get minimum values like zeros, maximum values. Now we are going to take zero as minimum, and after reaching maximum point to the minimum, we are going to take the reading. So here I'm getting minimum at the position of 9. Now we are going to calculate vernier readings. It is main scale and it is vernier scale. So distance in centimeters, we have to take main scale reading plus vernier scale into least count. Right now it is 10.1 is main scale reading and approximately 6 is vernier scale reading. This is your first minimum
location, that is D1. And again, we have to shift towards left direction. 0 reaches to the maximum and then coming to the downwards. Now it is second minimum. Now the reading is 12.4 in main scale reading and 3 is vernier scale reading. Again we are moving to the left direction. After certain time again it's rated to the minimum value. Now it is 14.8 is main scale reading and 3 is vernier scale reading. So it is D3, noted as D3. In this format you have to take D1, D2, D3 in centimeters. Verify with frequency obtained by slotted line section with direct method. Coming to the calculations, direct method we have frequency of 9.275 gigahertz. Coming to the indirect method, we have equal to 10.16 centimeters, D2 equal to 12.43 centimeters, where lambda j equal to 2 into D2 minus D1. By substituting these D1 and D2 values, we get 4.54 centimeters. Coming to the lambda c is 2 into a, where a is 2.286 centimeters, inner dimension of waveguide. So that is equal to 4.572 centimeters. Where lambda naught equal to lambda c lambda g divided by under root of lambda c square plus lambda g square. We get, by substituting this one, we get 3.22. Where fs equal to sample frequency, that is c by lambda naught, where c equal to 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters. By substituting this one, we get 9.31 gigahertz as indirect method. Now comparing both indirect method, we got frequency is 9.275 gigahertz. In indirect method, we got 9.31 gigahertz. And above experiment can be done by changing beam current, beam voltage, ripple voltages. Again, perform this same experiment by changing beam current to the 22 milliamps or 23 milliamps. And by changing repeller voltage also you have to perform the experiment. Whenever we are changing beam current, beam voltages and repeller voltage, there may be a chance to change our frequency. We have to find that frequency in direct method and frequency in indirect method.